Kim Bellisimo. Took a break, back in action. I am going to be planting bulbs today. And this has been just a dead space in my yard. And so I have been digging it. It's been totally dry, really hard to till the soil. But you know what, when you think about it, I'm planting because of the new moon, you know, planting my intentions in the bulb. And when you think about spirituality and people, you know, in spirituality, airy-fairy, does this look airy-fairy to you? Does this, you know, people can talk the spiritual talk, but beware, because some of that spiritual jibber-jabber is jibber-jabber. And, you know, you really, you know, when people have a language and, you know, they sound so spiritual, let's be real. Let's really just take it back down to nature. Let's just take it back down to the basics. And think about it. We are planning our intentions today, and I didn't realize how much hard work this is. I started this project, and I really needed a long break. And my soil still isn't ready. So think about it. Sometimes we feel in our lives, you know, we have these intentions and we've got so many, look at all this, we've got so many other roots, and these other roots are not even my roots. They're coming from my neighbor's house. So it's their roots in my space. And so, you know, what is the first thing we need to do? We need to create a space. In order to create anything, you must create a space. And so that's what we're doing. We're preparing a space. And then once you then once you create that space, you know, then we're going to, you know, make the soil, like fertilize the soil, add nutrients to the soil, and, you know, give energy to the soil. And then we're going to plant, you know, our bulbs. And then when we plant our bulbs, for those of you who just came, I am planting tulips for my new moon intentions. And, you know, we are moving through the process of what it's like to plant, because we're so disconnected, you know, of when we have an intention, the work it takes to really prepare and create something new. A lot of times we just kind of create over something and it just never happens, or we don't even prepare the soil enough, so it's not going to really grow. So this spiritual practice, does this look hairy-fairy? I'm very grounded. I'm very, you know, kind of, oh, look at this room. Like, look at that. I pulled out a huge brick in this. I pulled out tons of roots. And what I'm looking to do is kind of get the soil about 6 inches deep. And I thought, oh, you know, I'll do this in an hour, kind of like my organizing, but I underestimated. And it's coming. But look at right here. Look at how hard the soil is. Look at, that's what I've been digging in. Hi-ya! So, I had my son, he came home, I had him come out here. It's like, he couldn't even hardly dig in this. And so, he had to do too much homework. So he actually dug four, like, things, because he's got so much homework to do. So anyway, so this may take more than a day. What I'm going to do is put these videos together. When I break like this, I'll put them on YouTube, and I'll just compile them all together to show the process. Because, you know, we really want to make sure that the soil is completely turned and tilled. And Dexter, come over here and dig. Come over here and dig. Come over here. Dogs are supposed to dig. What is it? Everyone has forgotten how to dig. My son didn't know how to use a shovel. My dog, he's not digging. So, you know, I'm not hitting too many rocks though. I hit a big brick. about, I don't know if you wrote intentions down today, but it's a good day to do it. And if you could get your hands in the dirt today, like really get your hands in the dirt, or, you know, plant them somewhere. Plant them out in your yard. You don't have to maybe even dig the soil, but just getting back to nature, getting back to a ritual that our ancestors did. This is not like a spiritual hippy-dippy ritual. Does this look hippy-dippy to you? And look at, this is pretty amazing, because this part is really hard over here, but I'm almost done. This is pretty clear. Ha! So maybe it's taken, I don't know how long. But it's, we're working it. Hi-ya! And it's great to get out any, if you have any aggression. Hi-ya! Now, think about this. You have your intention, and we're gonna ground that thing. Hi-ya! And really move it in the ground. Create that space. Oh my gosh. That felt good. Ha! This is pretty hard back here. You know, if I dig even further down, then it's gonna go right into the water table, because we're on like landfill. So I'd love to see pictures of your garden. Or if you're not into gardening, I don't know a whole lot about gardening. I mean, I do it, just like I start relationships with things. I talk to plants, I talk to the soil. And when you do that, something begins to change. It's all about our relationships. And if you're involved with anything, like spiritual school or whatever, and it's not about being equal, get out. It's all about being heart connected. What does that mean? We're in a relationship. Without being connected, there is no relationship, and somebody's in control. So this is pretty good. I'm gonna start adding soil in. So I got my big bag. Right here, it's pretty hard, hold on. There. You know, you'd think I'd be able to just stick my shovel in and do it, but I'm going to add some soil in. It's going to help as I till it. Oops. Almost took out the dog there. So I just got some planting, organic planting soil, and we're going to add this in. See, you can use shovels for multiple purposes. So we're gonna just start to add some new soil in to make sure that the soil is perfect. So when we set those bulbs in, oh, look at that. Oh my gosh. So good. Oh, the smell of new soil. Look at that. You know, when I was digging through all of that, I was thinking, there is no way anything's going to grow in here. But just like in our lives, you know, if we don't place attention on certain aspects in our lives, nothing grows. And, you know, it's hard to break through. Like when we're starting something new, you know, we hit all these blocks. But look at how hard it is. I'm hitting blocks, I'm hitting roots, I'm hitting rocks, and I just keep going. The more I till the soil, the more I work with it, the more I move it, it becomes new. So I had to change my t-shirt because I had to do my wardrobe change because I was sweating. I don't sweat. And tell you that here's a rock. And who knows what you may find in your garden? Who knows what may be buried? Look at how nice this is. So, you know, an hour ago, I was just sweating. And now look at this. That looks so good. And then when the soil is really ready, we are going to water it. I have some fertilizer, actually tulip seed. And dogs kind of like to dig, but as we can see, my dog doesn't dig. Get over here and dig, Dexter. And so he's in the food, there's a lot of bone. And isn't that interesting when you think about it? Like, when we die, we're bones in the earth. And those bones actually give nutrients to the soil. So, you know, things have changed so much because, you know, in our society, it's all image, image, image. But we are embracing our farmer energy today. And, you know, the land. And we're looking for, you know, what in our life is hard, what in our life maybe is stuck. And all we're doing is we're just hi-ya, grounding into it, moving it, creating some space. Look at that. And when you do that, you know, miracles start happening. It's really being in relationship. As opposed to, I think people have forgotten the process in creating. So the first step, create a space. That's what we're doing. Creating a space, clearing a space, pulling out the dead stuff, getting rid of neighbor's roots, getting rid of what we don't want to grow in a space. And the next thing is we, you know, add to the soil. We give nutrients to the soil. We rebuild it. It's kind of like our body. We want to rebuild the body. And then that next phase is we're going to plant the seeds. You know, plant the bulbs. And then we're going to water it. We're going to nurture it. Here's the good thing, if you didn't hear earlier, the good thing about tulips, you want a spot that's dry. You want a spot that does not get watered all the time, because that way your tulips, they'll grow for eight years. They'll keep growing. But if you have a watering system, and maybe sometime if you want to learn how to do that, we'll do another video. Then they'll rot. So we're just going to water, you know, maybe this area once every 3 weeks. And we're just going to kind of leave it once we prep the soil. I'm going to add some more soil in. There's another root. There we go. And this is, you know, it just takes the time it takes. We just think about this. We wrote our intentions. We know what seeds we want to plant. We want to plant tulips. What seeds are you planting today? Maybe you can, you know, have as many things that you want to plant. Maybe there's something around your work that you want to create. Maybe you want a new way to express yourself. Maybe you want another step, new step. Maybe it's the same job, but you want more freedom, you want more joy. Or maybe, oh, this is a big group. Or maybe, you know, you're in a job and you have somebody that is a control freak. And because they are a control freak, they micromanage you. And when they do, it creates a lot of stress and anxiety. It's like their roots are coming into yours. I think this root is really, look at this root. gosh. Look at this thing. Wow. That is kind of cool. It's like an arm. Look at that. Whew. Can't believe I got that up. Now we're going to add a little more soil. And my phone might be running out of batteries. Just going to dump it in. And I'll see if I'm going to need more soil. I only bought one bag. Organic soil, and here are the tulips that I'm planting, a whole bag of them, 90 bulbs. So by springtime, this is going to be in full bloom. So I'd love to see maybe a space in your yard, you know, that you're working on. I'd love to see your yard. I'll have to do videos of my roses, because my roses are beautiful and they protect me. And see, look at this. From dry to look at how well the soil is changing. So many. So about your intentions, and then have another intention, especially, you know, with this new moon, we're working home space, body space, and clearing out your home, clearing out a space. That's what I did here, cleared out a space. Nothing was ever thriving here, so there was a dead tree here when we came, so I had to dig out those roots a long time ago. And then I never did anything with the space. And now we want to really, what kind of home space do we want? You know, what is the energy and what we really want to thrive in? And you get a relationship with nature, you get grounded to nature and the soil, you start talking to it, you will learn how to really create. Being in this process of, even if it's a symbolic process, you don't have to necessarily dig anywhere in your yard, but I'm just showing you that this is not some spiritual hippy-dippy, oh, let's just wear white robes and dance, you know? Nothing wrong with that, because I love doing that. I love that. But, you know, we can do all things. We can get back to our roots. And I guarantee you that our genetic line is connected there. So it looks like I think I'm going to need some more soil. And I may have to finish this project tomorrow. I don't know if I'm going to have time to go to the store. We're nearly there. So, in the new moon, you really have, maybe okay, you have 3 days to, before the full moon, after the full moon, where you're really focusing on those intentions, and I'm going to start to create a space now and plant them, and I can't believe it, but we are ready to plant the bulbs. I have been creating space, clearing space. This was just a dry mess. And now that I've tilled the soil, mixed good soil in it, I'm going to add a cup of bone food. It's like tulip food. And what I did is, you know, the tulips have to go down about 5 inches. So this is a half cup. Then what we're going to do, I added the dirt, I pushed the dirt along the side right here in the back, and there we go, that's perfect. And then what we're going to do is put the dirt on top. So I have set all of these bulbs at my intention. And what you want to do with tulips is you want to plant them with the tip up. So they're about, 3 to 4 inches apart. And I have a lot of them here. And so, you know, you can actually, even if they're not this way, the tips up, you know, they should sprout up and grow. Now, as you're doing this too, maybe for the next few days, because the rodents they like eating the tulips, so are the bulbs. So I'm gonna put a board over this so they can just kind of settle in here. And then we're just gonna, kind of easy to do when you think about it. You can just plant a lot of these bulbs. You know, once, if you have great soil, this would take you actually maybe 20, 30 minutes. It really would not take you that long to do. And I have another bag of bulbs, so I may have to, create some more space. I didn't want to get the dirt on my yard, but let's just get this other bag. And, you know, you can really plant a lot of them, and this place will be exploded in the springtime. You know, maybe I'll forget about them. When you plant your intentions of even what you want, the best thing to do is move it into the ground, even ground it, like an intention that you may have, and then it's connected to the sun, and the sun makes all things grow. So, and then you just water it. This you don't really need to even water. You're gonna just maybe once every few weeks. And I'm gonna bring this back a little more. That way we can plant those other bulbs. And maybe I'll make a row, some rows back here. We'll put this on the lawn. There we go. And I can put them even a little closer. Here, let's get that bag. And so you want to keep it tip up. It's about 5 to 6 inches deep, which I'll have a lot of soil over, so that won't be a problem. And, you know, then we're going to cover it. Once you cover it, you want to step on it, kind of like really make sure that soil, look at how nice the soil is. I don't know even how long that took me to do. It took me a long time to do, but I kept at it. It's not like I have a lot of muscle to do it, but I'm gonna plant these in here. And I have set all these and my intentions of what I want to manifest, and we'll see in the spring. I like doing this with my hands. We'll see this in the springtime come up, you know, around March. You know, it depends. Now these bulbs too, get out of there. Now you come over. See, he's coming over because the bone meal, that bone, you know, smells so good. And maybe I should have put that on the dirt in order for him to start digging. So, you know what I'm gonna do too is just put some over here, right here, right on the edge here. There's a lot of bulbs. A lot of these bulbs are from the Netherlands. There are some amazing bulbs, and they're kind of color, coated or whatever. So there's a variety of colors in this. So it's going to look fabulous. I think I'll plant some when I put this on top in the very back. I just didn't have room to take off the dirt. So here we go. We are going to, there were some bulbs in my yard, probably from, 50 years ago in my front yard. And those things have continually. Okay, now we are just going to cover it. Look at how nice the soil is. So, gardening can be noisy. Oh. And all of the soil is, oh, here's a, I have never really had a place when I had that dead tree back here, you know, and I love tulips and all the color of tulips. So, and I'm gonna get this dirt, bring it back over here. This is a lot of good dirt right here. So, and then once you get that done, you're just gonna walk on it, kind of step on it, kind of flatten it out. I'm gonna put a board on it for 2 days so that the rodents don't come and have their tulip dinner. So thanks for joining. This is what we created today and planted for our new intentions in the moon. I set the bulbs at the intentions that I wanted to plant. So let me know what you're planning, what your intentions are, and let's just continue to share and create and be in relationship in a new way. Love the life you live and live the life you love.